The Webflow CMS gives us full control over our dynamic content, and all of it is accessible through the CMS panel. In here, not only can you view a high-level overview of your CMS content, you can also manage your site's content at scale. With that in mind, we'll walk through how to build and customize a collection. We'll add some collection items. We'll talk about the different ways you can publish your CMS content. And finally, we'll show how to manage and edit your CMS content. Let's start with building a new collection. When it comes to creating a collection, roles with design permissions can set up the structure of the collection, which will act as the framework for anyone to work within, including marketers and content editors. To create a new collection, click on the plus icon in the top left corner. Webflow has pre-built templates for common use cases, but for us, we'll create a custom one from scratch. We'll give our collection a name. Let's call this one Blogs. And if we want, we can customize the collection URL to something else, but that's good for us. So we'll move on to set our collection fields. There's a lot we can add here, but let's start with a field for an image. Since this will be the thumbnail image for each blog post, let's call it thumbnail image. We can even add some help text that describes the purpose of this field, any parameters for this image, and whether or not this field is even required. Once we're done, we can click Save Field. And we can add the rest, like a field for the author. This is just a plain text field, publish date, a rich text field for the content. And all we're doing is defining and customizing the type of content for each item in the collection. Once we're done, we can go ahead and click Create Collection. And just like that, we have a collection with our own custom fields. At any time, you can go back into your collection settings to add, edit, or even delete custom fields as your needs evolve. But this is just a collection. We don't actually have any content yet. So now it's time to start adding collection items. We can start with sample items, but let's start with creating a new item and filling out our fields. For this post, we'll give it a name, which will be the blog title and will automatically generate the URL slug, upload a thumbnail image, paste in the blog content, and so on. We're just inputting the data related to this blog post. Everything's filled out and looks good, so let's go up to save this item. There are multiple things we can do here, but we'll cover that when we talk about publishing CMS content. So for now, let's make sure this item is saved. And just like that, we have our first blog post, our first collection item in our collection. And if we want, we can add more blog posts to fill out our collection. From there, the designer can use these data to design and build, because in order for us to see this collection content on our site, the content needs to be bound to the elements on the site through collection lists and pages. That was building our collection and its content. What about publishing CMS content? Earlier, when we created a collection item, we saved it as a draft, which saves the item but won't go live with the next full site publish. But what about the other options? Publish Now publishes that item to the live site immediately. This does not require a full site publish. Queue to publish means it will be published on the live site at the next full site publish. With Schedule, you can schedule the item to go live at any time in the future. This is based on the time zone set for the site under the site's settings. And finally, if you ever need to remove content from the published site, you can unpublish them. This takes it off the live site right away and sets it to draft. Whenever we're ready, we can choose the publishing option that makes sense, so we can publish and the world can see our new content. So that's publishing and even unpublishing your collection items. Now let's talk about managing all of it. Back into the collection, we can add new items, edit items, or delete items at any time. Let's click into one of our existing blog posts and make some changes. We can either save our changes or we can publish them right away. And we can also click on this eyeball to switch to the canvas to preview what this item will look like on the collection page, and even make changes right on the canvas. A purple outline indicates that that element is dynamic, meaning it's bound to a collection. So to edit it, just double-click it and make your changes. Editing content like this is great to see how your edits fit with the rest of the site design. Now, you'll see that the status changed from published to draft. That way, any changes I make here don't go live until I'm ready to publish them. Once I've made all my changes, I can click on the status indicator to view my publishing options, either publish now or queue to publish with the next full site publish. And remember, because we're working with dynamic content, any changes you make to that content apply to all instances where that content is being referenced. But what if you need to update multiple items at once? You can add or edit multiple collection items by importing a CSV file from your favorite spreadsheet tool. And for advanced workflows, you can programmatically manage your content with ease using Webflow's APIs or with Webflow apps in the marketplace. And at any time from the collection, you can select multiple items and set all of their statuses at once. But that's it. We talked about a lot, so let's recap what we did. We built and created a collection, as well as its custom fields. We added some collection items. We talked about different publishing and unpublishing methods. And finally, we covered the many ways to edit and update CMS content. But that's creating and managing collection content in Webflow.